Hello everyone, how are you? I hope everyone are all healthy and happy. In the last video, I have interesting question from Malani. It's about how I come up with my character name. I think this will be fun to tell you, especially about my webtoon Egnoid. Just for background, I made Egnoid concept when I'm very young. This is the old comics of Egnoid in year 2000. When I'm young, my English are not very good, so I just choose random words that I think cool to make the title of my comic. The Egnoid title itself are from the words humanoid and eggs. So I just changed the human part into eggs. So it's called Egnoid. The story itself are about human that comes from an egg pod. And for this comic, all the themes are about eggs. As you know, the protagonist of my webtoon Egnoid named Eggy. And the name itself comes from eggs. I know that global readers found it funny and hilarious, and they couldn't take Eggy name seriously. Some of you also DM me and message me and request for me to change Eggy name. I make Eggy name when I'm very young and don't know anything about English or English names. But Eggy name is a common name here in Indonesia. It's so common that I have 3 friends named Eggy back when my school days. So for me, it's an okay name. I don't think anything weird about Eggy. And also, Eggy have so much memories for me, because I made it in year 2000. So I don't find it hilarious. I have attachment to the name. And also in Korea, hilariously, Eggy means baby. So I like that name, and I think I wouldn't change it. It will be Eggy from first episode until the end. That's why Eggy name are Eggy, because this comics is all about eggs. Also for Kirana or Ran, it's also hilarious because in the past, in my first Egnoid comic, her name are Rano. Why I choose Rano? Because Rano means egg yolk in Japanese. So it's all about the eggs. But after I remade the Egnoid for a webtoon in 2015, I feel that Rano name are too Japanese, and I want names that are more strong to my root Indonesia and my culture. So I try to find name that are fit to Indonesian name, but I still be able to call her Ran. So I choose Kirana, because Kirana is Indonesian name, and for short I can still say Kirana. Kirana. So run, it's become run, just like my old comic. And Kirana names itself has a lovely meaning. Kirana means light or ray light. Also, Kirana make me decide her father name Chandra. Chandra means moon. And her mother name Putri. Putri means princess or daughter. So if I name Kirana Kirana Chandra Putri, the meaning are Kirana are the daughter of Chandra and Putri, or the other meanings are Kirana are the princess who have a moonlight rays, or princess that rays like a moonlight. It's a good name and click name for me, because I also like the Kaguya Hime story. Kaguya Hime is a princess that are from the moon and adopted by a mere human. So somehow the story are connected with Eknoid story itself. So I think Kirana names are just perfect. But I think the most elaborate names in Eknoid are for Kirana, because other names I just choose randomly, like Alfie or Rolf. Rolf Kent. Alfie are name that I took from the comic that I read when I'm young. I really like that name and I just took it. And for Grace, I don't have any ideas for female character, so I just tell myself the first name that I saw, if I open my Facebook, that's gonna be her name. So I open my Facebook and the first name I saw is Grace, so I took it. And for Rami is Alfie's friend, one who have glasses and pale hair. Rami is the name that suggested by my friend, who also my Patreon. So for his Patreon rewards, I make a character based on him. So that's easy. So, you know, for random character and side character, I just took it from random people around me. Yeah. So I feel that choosing character name sometimes easy and sometimes hard. It's easy if you choose this random one. It's hard if you want to have some meanings or connection with the story and have like conspiracy thing. That's going to be hard. But now there are baby names and meanings on the internet, so you just choose it what best that's suitable for your character. To make it easy, you can write down on the note and bullet point things that are connected or relatable the most to your character, like is it color, is it place of birth, is it animals, is it characters, attitude, or zodiac, things like that. And you know, the bullet point will make you easier to find names that are suitable for your character. So that's my tips, I guess. And that's the history behind Ignoid names. I hope that interesting to listen to and give you some inspiration or help if you want to find names for your character. And see you next time on the next video. Thank you for listening and bye bye.